Podcast is sponsored by Easy Excel. Learn Excel from Mr. Excel Podcast, episode 1624. Most popular functions, number 12 now and number 13 today. Hey, welcome back to the Mr. Excel netcast. Well, we started this over the summer, the series of the most popular Excel functions. We got the first couple episodes done, 1553 with sum, 1556 with average, and then I started writing the book. So we're coming back here to kind of working this. Today we're going to do number 12 and 13. 12 is the now function, and 13 is today. Two very related functions. So let's say that we have a list of projects and a list of due dates, and I need to calculate how many days away those projects, those due dates are. Okay, well, today is 12/27/2012, so I could add a little column here that that I would come in and update every single day. And then, of course, the days until due is just a simple little calculation of 12/27, actually the due date, January 2nd minus 12/27. That's going to give us an answer of 6. Copy that down. And you see, oh, wow, those are late. Those were due yesterday. I better get on it. Okay, so, you know, in theory, you'd come in every day, update this cell, and you could calculate the number of days due. However, there is a better way to go, and the function that most people seem to use is equal now. And let's see, returns the current date and time, formatted as a date and time. All right, so you see that it's 6:22 a.m. on December 27th. So how can we use now to simplify this? Well, one way is we'll just get rid of all of these calculations, get rid of that column. Days until due is equal the due date minus now. All right, now see, they weren't smart enough to format that correctly, so we have to go in and format it as a number. Right there, that's the problem. So it's 5.73 days until this is due. That's not really 5.73 days, it's 6 days. And the fact that there's 0.73 days left until midnight tonight, that really doesn't help me. So I want that to be 6, and one solution is to decrease the decimals, right, which is going to round everything, and that's going to work perfectly until I get back from lunch. When I leave for lunch at 11:59, that's going to say 6. When I get back from lunch, actually anytime after noon, this is going to change to 5. And if something's due tomorrow, if something's due on the 28th, here, let's just change this, this will say 1 day until it's due, until after lunch, then it'll say, no, hey, it's due today, it's 0 days due. So, you know, while I've used this method in the past, I'm not a big fan of it. So we have equal now, which gives us date and time. You could always use equal int of now, which gives us midnight this morning at 12:27, but instead of that, you can do equal today. Today returns the current date formatted as a date. So today and now are very similar. The difference is now is giving us the date and time. Today is just giving us the date, 12/27. So coming back up here to fix our formula, instead of subtracting now, we'll subtract today. Copy that down, and no matter how many decimals we show now, it's always going to say, you know, hey, this is the things due tomorrow or 1 day away. So there you go, the difference between now and today. Hey, I want to thank you for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another netcast, Mr. Excel.